Welcome to RPF. In this video, we'll discuss about folder operation in Microsoft Power Automate. So whenever we are working into any project or automations project that will require to work on creation of folder, deletion, copying the folder data, and even folder, and we can also require to move data and folder from one location to the other locations, as well as creating empty folder. So these all app operations will be required to perform automatically rather than doing manually. Generally, this process will help us to make our complete automation package. So we'll see here which all operations we can perform in folder operation using Microsoft Power Automate. So first operations I am taking here, creation of folder. So if you want to create any particular folder, so here I will specify the folder locations where I want to create the folder. So I will select file operation folder, okay. And here I have to specify the name. So with which name I want to create it. So I am giving the name as folder operation. So it will create a new folder for me whenever the script will run. And you can see here, we don't have the folder here with that name. Now, next, I want to delete the folder. Or rather than doing delete operation immediately, let's create a copy of folder. So here, I will specify downloads, file operations. I want a copy of the folder, destination folder. I want within that only file operations. I will create it here. And if folder exists, create or maybe add inside task 2. So here we'll copy the same folder into file operation task 2. So if that folder is exists, we are not doing anything. Even we have the options of override. So whenever we will perform these operations, it will automatically create a variable. So let's save it and run the process. So first, whenever the script will execute, it will create a folder and then copy the folder from task 3 to task 2. So exactly same folder has been created, folder operation, and we also have the task 3 folder copied from one location to the other locations. Let me delete it. Now let's see the other operations. So here let's delete the folder. So inside that we'll perform delete folder from task 2. We don't have any folder available. Let's run this so that we will have copied of folder. Now, if you can see, task 2 contains task 3 folder. So this time we will delete those folder. So downloads, file operations, then task 2. And in task 2, we have task 3 folder. So it will delete automatically. Next, if we want to empty the folder, so better first run this delete folder operations. Now, second operation will create a folder in task 2 and that will be immediately deleted because of delete activity. So let me remove it. Here, we also have the data in task 3. So we are running so that we can make sure that data is available in task 3. So you can see these are the files available under task 2 and task 3. So inside task 3, we have these files, which is under task 2 folder. So let me rename it exactly. So this is making empty. Okay. Now, this time I want to empty the folder. So I will use here task 2, and I want to empty this folder. So whatever data is available inside that folder, it will be automatically deleted. It means that will create an empty folder. Again, we have the folder, but data is not available. Right? So next operations, we want to perform the move file. So in move file, what we will do, we have to move folder. So let's see. Downloads, file operation, and here we have making empty folder available. I want to move this folder into second under file operation. We have folder operations. I want to move this empty folder into folder operations. So let's run this flow. As of now, this is our folder path where we have task under task 2, we have task 3 and making empty folder, which does not contain any data. It means making empty folder does not have any data. I want to move that folder into folder operations. So let's run the process. Now, this time we have this making empty folder available into folder operations. So this is how we can perform copy, create, delete, move, and empty. These operations we have done quickly. So this is how we can work around with folder operations like creation of folder, copying the folder from one folder to the other folder, moving data or moving folder from one location to the other locations, deleting the folder or creating or making empty folder that contains data, which is a part of folder operations. Next, all this activity will cover it in next part of video. So that's all from this video. Hope you enjoyed the content. If you think so, this will be useful. Don't forget to share within your circle. Thank you for watching.